Okay, and so what I'm pretty sure is going to be my last video on this night sky stuff here is I thought I would just tell you at least a little bit of one thing you can see if you sort of look to the south now. Remember, we're spending most of our time looking to the north at the North Star, Cassiopeia, Big Dipper, that sort of thing. But now if we look to the south a little bit, there's actually something kind of interesting, which again, your campmates might find just fascinating. I always do. So what I'll do then is I'll sort of draw what you see, if you can sort of spot this at the right time of the night, is you'll see something that looks like this. It's a whole bunch of stars, and I'm probably not even getting the number right, but you can sort of pick out a pattern that just looks like this. It's just a whole bunch of stars, and it's very difficult to piece all this together, but it looks something like this. So this is part of the constellation called Scorpius, which has to do with being a scorpion, again, according to the mythological stories here. One star in particular, as you sort of go away from this sort of round arc here, and this sort of the body of the scorpion, this is the big sort of whippy-like tail here, but one of the stars right around here is big and orange like this, and this is Antares. Okay, that's sort of the name of that star. They're big and red like that. And the interesting part about Antares and Scorpius and being in the southern part of the sky then is, let me move this over a bit more to give myself a little more room. So sorry about that, something like that. Then what is right next to Scorpius, if you can ever find these, is A, that big red star Antares there, which sort of defines the constellation a great deal to me. And I'll show you some of the constellation art on this in just a second. But if you look a little bit over in this region now, if you can find Scorpius, my little story can continue here. You'll find something that's sort of known as a teapot. I'll try to draw this just as carefully as I can. Look, something like this and like this, and maybe like this and like this. And maybe there's a star up here. There's a bunch of stars. It's kind of easy to get this one wrong here, but it sort of looks like this. And let me connect all the dots now a little bit, like this. And you can see that when you put it all together, it looks just a little bit like a teapot, okay, something like that. So maybe this is the spout of the teapot right here. This is the cap. And this would be the body of the teapot where all the nice warm water would go if you're making tea or something. And so I'll just go ahead and say that this is actually sort of informally known as the teapot. And I'll show you the graphics on this in the simulator in just a second. But the most important part about this is if you can find Scorpius, the scorpion, with the big red Antares as your clue there, and you can sort of work out the teapot, then it turns out that right here, right at this spot right here between the two, right about there, X marks the spot, that is the direction to the center of our galaxy. And that's something that you could say, point out, or just sort of know, and it's just sort of a cool thing to find. So you're getting very good at that point of recognizing things in the night sky. Scorpius, the scorpion, with Antares right there, and Antares is another big red star, definitely looks reddish in the sky. If you can work out the teapot right there, that's just awesome. Another little pattern you can recognize in the sky, and of course, X marks the spot. You can just tell your campmate to convince yourself, hey, I'm looking in this direction towards the center of our galaxy. Okay. So here's what I'm talking about in the night sky. So you can see here that I'm sort of looking to the south here a little bit. There's west over there, and there's east over there. And sort of to capture this, I've sort of looked in all directions here, but I think I have it. So the labels are showing me Antares here. There's sort of that group of stars that are sort of bent, forming the head of the scorpion there. Then the body goes through the big red Antares over there. Then the tail sort of whips up the way you'd expect. So let me go ahead and turn on the lines here that are connecting them, and you can sort of see what I'm talking about here. This is the head of the scorpion, Antares around the neck, and there comes the big tail whipping around. Very, very difficult to sort of map this out exactly in the night sky just with your eyes, because there's so many stars that could possibly be made of it. And if I look more carefully then over here a bit more, you can see, I'm just sort of circling right here. Here is the teapot that I was talking about here. So, oops, here's the spout right here. Here's the body of the teapot. There's the cap right there. And there's sort of maybe the handle or something. And you see the teapot is an asterism, which is part of a larger group of stars there. And so anyway, right here where I have the mouse cursor then, right about there, that would be pointing towards the direction of the center of our galaxy. Okay, and what do I mean by that? Well, I'll try to pull this in so you can see it here. But if I pull this into the shot here, this is sort of what we think our galaxy looks like. This is not an actual picture. I don't know if we'll ever get a picture of our galaxy to be able to put some camera or a spaceship outside of our galaxy and take a picture of it, but they think it's a whirlpool galaxy. It's the kind of thing like trying to figure out what the outside of your house looks like by walking around inside of it or something. That's sort of what we've done. So anyway, we think we're around here. That's one of the little bright dots there would be something like our sun. And when you're looking at that X marks the spot between Scorpius and the teapot, you're looking in this direction towards the center of our galaxy. That's what you're doing. So you're looking from the blue dot over towards the right here like that, towards the center of our galaxy. And I just think that's pretty cool. And that is what you're seeing here, that if you get on a really nice, dark, clear night, which you can see in San Luis Obispo once in a while, all of this stuff right here is that inner disk plane of our galaxy. So the galaxy is a big flat disk, and all of this stuff that you're seeing there is sort of this part of it, the nebular dust and some of the other stars in our galaxy. That's sort of what you're seeing as you look at it towards the center like that, right around there, looking towards the center.